We are asked, what number should replace the A and B in the multiplication table? So let's just make sure we can read this multiplication table. The way you think about it is, if you wanted to figure out, it goes up to 6, so if you want to figure out what any number up to 6 times another number up to 6 is, this table will tell you. So for example, if you wanted to figure out what 3 times 2 is, you say, okay, 3, let me take the row that has this 3 in it, and then the column for the 2, so 3 times 2, so if you're in this row, the 3 row, and you're in the 2 column, 3 times 2 is going to be 6 here. Or another, you could go the other way around. This 12, this means that 3 times 4 is 12. Or right over here, this 25. Notice this is the same row as this 5 and the same column as that 5. So it's saying that 5 times 5 is 25. And so you notice that if you go in any row, you're counting by that number. And if you go in any number, if you go in any column, you're also counting by that number. So for example, in this 2's column right over here, you're counting by 2's. 2, 4, 6, 8. In this 5 column, you're counting by 5's. 5, 10, 15, 20. And that makes sense, because 5 times 1 is 5. 5 times 2 is 10. 5 times 3 is 15. 5 times 4 is 20. And the same thing is happening as you go up a row. 2, 4, 6, 8, because 2 times 1 is 2. 2 times 4 is 4. On and on and on, you're counting by 2's. Here you're counting by 6's. 6 times 1 is 6, 6 times 2 is 12, 6 times 3 is 18, 6 times 4 is 24. So hopefully now we understand the multiplication table, and it is actually pretty cool to just keep looking at and thinking about how it works. But let's answer the question, what would A and B be? Well, we have this A right over here. So one way to think about it, it needs to be whatever 4 times 4 is. And you might know that 4 times 4 is 16. 4 times 4 is 16. Or another way is you could just go down this column and count by 4's. 4, 8, 12, and then you add 4 again. 12 plus 4 is 16. Now let's figure out what B is. And actually, let's do it that way. If you were to, B is in this column, so we can count by 3's. 3, 6, 9, add 3 to that, you get to 12. So B could be 12. Or you could go from the row. You could go 4, 8, add 4 to that, you get 12. And that makes sense because this, where B is, that should be whatever 4 times 3 is, because 4 times 3 is 12. Then they say complete the inequalities with the greater than, less than, or equal symbol. So A is greater than B. Greater than, and I always remember the greater than symbol because it is opened to the number on the left. The number on the left is greater than, it's open to the larger number. A is greater than B because 4 times 4 is going to be greater than 4 times 3. Is greater than 4 times 3. Right? 4 times 4 is greater than 4 times 3. It makes sense. You have, I guess if you view 4 times 4 as 4 4s, and if you view 4 times 3 as 3 4s, you have more 4s here. So hopefully that makes sense. Let's do a couple more of these. So now what number should replace A and B in the multiplication table? So same idea. So A should be whatever 4 times 5 is. So it should be 20. Or you could look at whatever row or column it's in. If you look at its column, 5, 10, 15, 20. Now let's do the same thing for B. B should be whatever 5 times 4 is. Well, that's going to be 20 as well. That's going to be 20. And you could say, well, like A is going to be 4 times 5, which is 20, and B is going to be 5 times 4, which is 20. So either way you look at it, they're the same. So complete the inequalities. Well, A is equal to B because 4 times 5 is the same thing as 5 times 4. It doesn't matter what order you multiply them in. Let's do one more of these. I think you're getting the sense of it. So what is A? So we see it's where it's located. It's in this row for this 2. And the column for the 6. So it needs to be whatever 2 times 6 is, which is 12. And you could count by 6's. 6, 12, or you could count by 2's. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12 to get to A. Now B, this is going to be whatever 6 times 2 is. Well, that's going to be 12 again. It'll be 12 again. And so it's just like the last one we saw. A is going to be equal to B because 2 times 6 is equal to 6 times 2. Let's do one more. This is actually a lot of fun. All right. So A is whatever 4 times 1 is, which we know is going to be 4. B is going to be whatever 1 times 4 is, which is also going to be 4. And I think you see a pattern here. A equals B, because 4 times 1 is the same thing as 1 times 4.